Welcome to Technique Friday with Els. Today I'm going to show you how to assemble the pillow box with the handle. Here I have a few samples on the table. So this is one, how fun for treats for kids, happy birthday. So this is one of the Jungle Cuties stamps from Krista Schneider. Then here we have the dancing butterfly on here from Moda Scrap. And here is another, that's the from the set The Feathered Friends, also from Krista Schneider, and this is from the stamp set from Josette. A Lovebirds on this one, it's one that Selma created. Kelly Booth made this one, and Sandy Diller, I know, did that one. These are the feathers from Josette and the background. Just so many possibilities for kids for any occasion. So this is the die, and you will see right away it is a big die. So how that works is, if you have long plates, very easy of course, because it will just fit in between the plates. And I know a lot of people have those already. If you don't have the long plates, you can also work with the smaller ones. So you just put it in there with your paper and tape, of course, and then you run it through once and you slide your plates to the other side and you run it back and forward. So it's very easy also with the shorter plates. And then I have a tip how I work with it, with the box. So I take the cardstock and then I take a piece of double-sided adhesive, and that's going to make sure that that handle is totally closed. Instead of doing a wet glue or just some strips of tape, it's very easy when you take a piece of double-sided adhesive, and I'm going to stick it at the top here. And then I take my die, and I'm going to line it up where the handle ends. So you can see here, the handle ends here. So I'm going to line it up where the handle ends. I'm going to take two pieces of repositionable tape. So on both sides, I can clearly see where that handle ends. You glue it on there and then you run it through your machine. So you run it through your Big Shot, Cuddlebug, any die cutting machine. And then when you've die cut it, you will have this. You see, and now I have exactly here where that handle is, I have my tape. And then I can see the score lines. And depending on the paper you're using, heavy cardstock, it does matter sometimes. If you don't see the embossed lines that well, you can run it through extra. That's with all the embossed lines on every box. You can run it through again and then using the embossing mat that all the machines have as an extra. But in this case, with this cardstock, and you will not see it, but I can clearly see, and I didn't run it through extra, but I can clearly see all the embossed lines. But on the camera, it might be difficult. So I just kind of follow all those lines, you see? So just fold it over. So kind of make it go already. And then I'm going to close my box first. So now I'm going to take this off, you see? So I'm going to take my release sheet from my double-sided adhesive. So now my handle is fully sticky. Fold it and line it up nicely. If you just close it nicely, of course, it will fold nicely as well. You see, so now I have my handle here, and then you're going to close it. And when you close it, you make sure kind of you can kind of make it a little bit like this. You close the one with the piece out of here, like the half circle out of here first, because then it's easier to open it again. So that one closes first, and then you close the solid one. So without the handle, or without the extra piece out of there. So just close it like this, follow the line, here you go. And you do the same with the other side. So close the one where that little part is out there first, and then you fold the second one. There you go, and then you have your pillow box. Sharp it a little bit here. You see, so then you have your box. And then with this one, you can see I added that dancing butterfly on there. And I'm going to show you how I glitter that, because as you can see, that is a very detailed die. So to die cut that through cardstock and tape on top, that's very hard, unless you do it the way I did it here. So here you see I have my cardstock, so I took purple cardstock because I knew I was going to use lavender. So then instead of using a white cardstock, I used a colored cardstock. So I have a colored cardstock with the adhesive on this side, so on the back, and then I put my die on the front of the card, so on the cardstock side and not on the tape side, because when you put it on the tape side, it will be hard to cut all the way through. So what I'm going to do now, I can take this out. So I'm just going to push it out, and then you will see, so that's my die, and you will see I can lift up that butterfly and the release sheet will stay behind, because I did not cut all the way through that release sheet. So the die on the cardstock side and the tape on the back. So now I have, this is adhesive, so now I can glitter this, so that's all sticky now. So then I'm going to take my, in this case, my lavender silk microfine glitter. I'm just going to dump it in there, and then I'm going to just dip it in here, this side, dip it in here, that side, so there's glitter everywhere. Tap it off, and then you're going to polish it. So polishing means you're going to rub that glitter into the tape. I forgot my Swiffer, so now I got shiny fingers. So normally make sure you have a Swiffer at hand. So now here I have my butterfly, going to fold the wings a little bit, and then I'm going to take a little bit of the kids glue, and I can just do it with my finger here, and I'm just going to add a little bit of glitter of a glue, sorry, in the center of the butterfly, because of course I want those wings up, and then you can just stick it on here and leave it to dry, you see, and then you have your treat box. Can you imagine, white on white will be perfect as well, will be beautiful. And so that's your treat box. And before I'm going to say goodbye for this time, I want to show you our catalog. This is a beautiful catalog with all the products in there from 2016 and the first release of 2017. Look at that, all kind of ideas. You will find it on our website. You can download it. These are all the new stamps from Krista. And of course we have the coordinating dies in there. Lots and lots of samples in here. And of course, let's start here, you see. Beautiful samples in there from all our design team members as well. Here you go. And here are the brand new ones from Josette. And then Suzanne. Beautiful, Suzanne Cannon, beautiful, beautiful catalog. So that's it for today. Thank you for watching. I've suggested a couple of videos that I think you might like as well. See you next time.